Greetings, everyone. How are y'all this fine Thursday? Give me a moment to get out the background music. Okay. Okay, so allow me to explain what we are doing today, because I have a list. Indeed I do. So I literally wrote this down at like 3 in the morning. So yeah. So currently there's like a few things here. So the first thing is debut presentation parts, because I kind of need to make those. Mostly just like text box and doodles. Then emojis for the Discord and for when I get to affiliate. Patchouli's Revenge. Pinch Portrait Sprites, which is probably just going to be like sketches. Patchouli's Revenge Character Profiles, which, for those who aren't sure what those are, well, there's two. Two versions. There's this, where it's kind of like the concept. Like the very first concept to kind of like get them down. And then there's the Tumblr intro, which has like a half body. And has some information here on the left. And then if there's the VTuber model ref, aka the reference for my VTuber model. Which I plan on like I might redo the doing today. And for the emojis, I do have a list of the ones that I still need to make. But I might make another one where it's just the animated emojis. And I'm going to try my best to not do that right now. And I did take an animation class. Like, it was one of the first classes that I took back in like my second ever semester. So like 2023. Something about the bodies doesn't really feel right. Actually, I think I know why it looks a little weird. It's because the pelvis is kind of leaned forward a little bit. Shit. I did not mean to move the gesture. this looks better. Okay. 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 So for anyone wondering why I made the thumb, not, completely accurate to this, why I made this thumb a little shorter, that's because my thumb is actually pretty, my thumbs are actually pretty short in real life. In fact, they're not even symmetrical. I quite literally have a thumb that is referred to as a toe thumb because it looks like a toe. It looks like the big toe. That's why I probably should have pulled my keyboard forward earlier. But eh. Thank you. Actually, hold on. Looks good. Also, the feet, I'm not going to like add a lot of detail to because they're going to be covered by shoes anyway. Unfortunately, Clip Studio Paint doesn't really have, like, plus-sized models. Like, I mean, I could probably, like, just maximize the length of the width of the arms. But even then, like, so something that a lot of like people who are not plus sized, especially when it comes to like clothing manufacturers, something they don't really realize is that fat affects the arms. Like, the arms have a good amount of chub on them as well. That's why in like older people, the upper her arm from skin sags, because it's kind of like a part where it's a little loose. Like, that's where some fat goes. Fat and muscle, of course. But a lot of clothing manufacturers, at least from my experience, they make the sleeves a little too tight on this arm. Especially, I notice this a lot in t-shirts and stuff. And it literally, after some time, it gets uncomfortable, okay? Like, to a point where I just don't want to tolerate it. Thank you, Windows. Very cool. I did not need that. But yeah. Also, I probably need to, like, link a PNG of the eyes from the model. So I can, like, put them here. Of course, it's probably going to end up being a little bit crushed. And I'll have to, like, redraw them. I'm a little... I'm probably going to like add some design notes as well. Like for the geographic tongue, and especially like as an example, you don't have to like go with exactly what the model shows because the patches on it change over time. You can kind of make it like look like any map. Like, hell, you can make the geographic tongue look like the Skyrim map. I don't care. Or you can just make it look like a funky little thing. Like a little funny meme. You know, as a little Easter egg. In fact, probably if I ever like make any finished pieces with my model character, if she has her tongue sticking out, I might like just put memes on the tongue, like silhouettes of like memes, like Ratatouille, like Remy Ratatouille. Or the guy who just does it to him. Yeah. And along with that, there's of course... Wait. What the model that I'm currently... Hello! Hooray! How are you? Sleepsy. Understandable. So, quick question to anyone who is willing to like chat in the chat. Would the model that I'm currently using right now be considered a 1.0 model or just a 3D concept as I've been referring to it as for the past like year or two? Which one would y'all consider it to be? 3D concept or 1.0? I personally consider this the 3D concept because, as you, no clue. Yeah, I mean, so 1.0 is basically like usually the first model a VTuber has, mostly in terms of like live 2D. You've been watching for like 2 days, yeah. So, 1.0 models usually are like the first model that a VTuber has. This is usually more apparent with like agency VTubers, or who. Words. Basically, like, usually after they stream for like a year. Here they can get like a 2.0, and basically it's usually like a new outfit, or in case of some VTubers, they like completely change the model art and style. Like they get a new artist to do a new model, well, for them. Yeah. I mean, I am probably like the first VTuber you've watched, Ray. Based on what you are saying in chat. So you probably like don't know a lot of the terms and stuff. Which is completely understandable. But basically, 1.0 is like the original model that a VTuber starts with, or like their first official model. Yeah. Watch a bit of shorts on YouTube, but that's about it. Yeah. But basically, when it comes to like a 2.0, usually this is like a completely new, different model from their first model. Actually, hold on. So, man, it's. I plan on using like so. I'm using, so for example, this is Shoto. He is one of the most well-known independent VTubers, and this is his 1.0 model. And of course, he does have a 2.0 a model. He actually has a few new models since then because he's been a VTuber for quite a long time. Okay. so it's okay. Yeah, I like going on tangents. Okay. And this is his 2.0 model. So as you can see, there's... They look relatively the same. Most likely they used the same base. He's like model without like all the clothing and stuff. But this is like the usual version of a 1.0 versus a 2.0. Yeah, different clothing. Yeah, color scheme remained the same. It's okay. Hey, sometimes the U is like negligible. But yeah, sometimes you get like a whole like art style change. I don't really have like a specific example for like which VTuber who I know of that did the whole style change. Which, if the model, the art style changes between the 1.0 and 2.0, that usually means they have a new mama. Yeah. For American English, yeah. What'd you learn? So, basically, in terms of like, this is more of like VTuber specific lingo, but a model mama and a model papa are the people who drew the model and did the rig, respectively. Like, mama, like, a model mama is usually, like, the artist. And the papa is the one who did the rig in Live 2D. And it... Therefore, it's not like really gendered, even though the origin of the term comes from a gendered word. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cause Progam and Manly and Jonathan male. Yeah, probably. But it's not really like gendered in the VTubing sphere. Like, you can have a male artist who drew your model, and they would probably be still referred to as the model mama. But then, and even if there's like, if you have like a female person and who did your rig, then they would likely still be referred to as the papa. So it's not really like, yeah. I know, my model is scuffed, unfortunately. It's kind of like tracking. And I literally have my camera that I use for my tracking on top of my drawing tablet, so it probably looks a little weird because I'm, you know, looking down on the screen, you know, a lot of the time. Hopefully, once my Live 2D model is finished, this will kind of like change. And I probably also need to like, yeah. Pupils are freaking out. How to open and close differently. Yeah, mouth goes wow, wow, wow. All closed, all. Yeah. Unfortunately, that's kind of like the scuff. When it comes to the model, I probably need to like recalibrate Okay. Yeah. But to be fair, like, yeah. Well, I do care a little bit. It doesn't, like, bother me that much. But I do, of course, probably need to, like, redo, like, the calibration for the model. Whole tracking. But luckily, yeah, sometimes, like, it can kind of, like, make a scuffed model part of your brand. Completely valid. It do have me on a different screen. Drawing is a reference sheet. Basically, kind of like for my fellow artists who want to draw fan art of me, or of my model, or especially if I'm like commissioning someone to do art for me. It's important that I kind of have a reference. So that it's kind of. That isn't just my model. It's kind of like a courtesy for artists to kind of have like a reference, so it's easier for them to kind of make fan art. Yeah. 2D version for other people? Well, technically. But this is mostly for like, if I ever like commission someone, or they kind of want to make fan art. And of course, I'm making this model pretty simple. Because, one, this is my first ever time doing live 2D. And two, the more complex the design is, the less likely you're going to receive fan art. That's kind of like why a lot of like super complex designs. Well, that's kind of why, like. So, the more complicated the design is, the more messier the silhouette. And the less likely people are going to be. The less likely that anyone will be willing to either make fan art or accept commissions from you. Who of, you know, the model. It's kind of like. It's kind of a fine line between, like, making a model too simple and making a model too complex. because if you make a model too simple, it won't stand out from the crowd not as easily compared to, like, a more, you know, complex model. But if you make the model too complicated, then people will be intimidated to draw it, and therefore you will probably, like, sorry, the termite guy is here. And was going to go into my room, but, you know, I'm kind of busy. And now I kind of lost my tangent. But anyway, the more complicated a model is, the less likely you'll be able to find someone who is willing to, like, draw the model and rig it. And if you are, it's probably going to be, like, super expensive. And that is kind of like part of the reason why a lot of models are very expensive. Because there's like a lot of detail that goes into these models. So, the model isn't just, like, all the stuff you see here. Like, there is, like, I kind of had to, learn my lesson with this. But when I, you know, was doing the head tilts, I realized that the neck was too short because you could kind of see where the neck stops. Hops over here. Quick question, why are a lot of YouTuber models either mega busty or not busty? Well, it's kind of like personal preference, most likely. Unfortunately, there isn't really like a solid answer that I can really give. But there are like certain like anime archetypes that they're most likely following. So that's probably why a lot of them are, you know, very busty. They're kind of like following like anime archetypes and stuff because the VTubing style is like very much heavily influenced by anime and Japanese idol culture. So, yeah. That's probably why. Yeah. Well, it's kind of that too. But some people just like, I kind of like how it looks on a rig. Like, kind of like the extra bounce that you get with the physics. Though it can get a little crazy. And even though my model is, like, busty, I'm not going to, like, put a lot of emphasis on the booba physics. Most of the physics are going to go into the hair. But yeah, kind of like what you said. Anime boobs are good for content. That's kind of like the big reason. Yeah. Yeah. That's understandable though. But I do want to kind of like make the comparison since my model is also one of the busty ones. Like, depends on, like, it kind of depends, like, that's probably what you're being shown because that's probably, like, what is the most popular of, you know, the VTubers. Like, the most well-known ones. The Orca Lady? Are you referring to Shy Lily? That's probably the Orca VTuber. Yeah. She actually has, like, a really good rig. And a lot of the good parts of the rig are, like, emphasized because she does, like, a lot of, you know, expressions with her face and stuff. Yeah. I believe her Life 2D model was, like, $8,000, like, the first one. And fun fact, she actually started off as a 3D VTuber. So she did not start off with the 8K model. But she went with something cheaper. Of course, 3D models can be very expensive, but they're also one of the most accessible models. Because Vroid Studio, which is how I made this model, is free. So, yeah. That's kind of like the theme with a lot of different models. Yeah. Free indeed. Ish the free. In fact, a lot of aspects of VTubing come from, like, stuff that can be easily accessible. Like, there are plenty of, like, free-to-use VTuber assets. Like, I even made some of my own free-to-use assets. It's that I upload on Ko-fi. And of course, these can be used even if you are, you know, not a VTuber. So, yeah. It all, like, kind of depends. So yeah. How long did I continue? I went for like, hold on, let me check. I went for 3 hours and 22 minutes. It's yesterday. Which was kind of surprising to me. But that was like about half the time that I streamed him back on Tuesday. But I'm going to save this for now. And I'm going to intermission, kind of let the termite guy go into my room and check for termites. And I probably also need to like separate my emoji list between like static and animated. So yeah. I'm going to do the intermission. I should be back within like 5 to 10 minutes, depending on how long the termite guy kind of like is in my room for. So, be right back! Okay, I'm back. So, apparently the termite guy left because we kind of like you could barely like see the walls, investigate the walls anyway because we have so much fucking shit. So I wrote down the animated and static emojis on a separate list, and since some of them were already drawn, I excluded those. But I have like three static emojis that I can do, and five have that are animated that I can also do. So, yeah. I got plenty of things to do. So, I'm going to remove that fucking apostrophe. So, one of the things that I have listed here is the presentation part for my debut, which okay. I actually already have the slides, like some of the slides. But they are like very, very bare bones. So, yeah. So, of course, this is like the text box. Yeah, box of testing. Well, technically, text. TEXT. But, yeah. So, the text is Alice, the typeface is Alice, and the points, it's a 12 point. Okay. Okay. Hold on. I need... Hold on. Okay. Okay. So I had to kind of check the, apparently you can also use like HTML in Google Slides, which is good because I know how to do HTML, at least a little bit. So now I need to like probably like figure out where I need to figure out what to do for the box. Corner sparkles. Actually, this is probably going to be like what the border looks like. Like, if I'm able to, like, make the brush shape a diamond. Of course, I'll have to like do some like testing and stuff, but of course, hopefully, I will be able to like. You know, yeah. Oh, you gotta go? Okay. See you later, Ray. To like make several versions of this once I, you know, figure out like how to make the text box. So I'm going to separate these. To like so right, I probably need to like also import the arms and legs. So I probably also need to like change these. Of course, I'm probably going to like add this stuff later. There's a bunch of geese in my fucking yard. What the fuck? And they have goslings. God. Fuck. Not what I meant to do. Photo. Hold on, I'm sending it in that picture to the group chat. Well, my family group chat. It's taking a while to send. It's just being a pain with sending. I'll send it to them later. Okay. So now I gotta figure out what to do. I think I'm going to work on this. Hold on. I'm gonna text my mom. There's an airplane! Okay, that sent. I just have to. Okay, so just like, what's going on? Hopefully they don't walk into my house. Hello, Crow! There are currently geese in my backyard. I can see them from my window! I've never seen them! Yes, geese! Canadian geese! Sounds like dinner? No, I'm not eating the geese! Besides, we're not a hunting community. Well, they could have diseases. And it's probably not a good idea for us to kind of, like... Here's the geese! Also, I'm allergic to their feathers. And so is my dad. But here's the goose and here are the goslings. But yeah, we don't really have a hunting light. We live in the suburbs, I'm pretty sure, like... I'm pretty sure... Like, given that I live in the suburbs, it's probably not a good idea for me to try and eat the geese. Now, if I was in Wisconsin, and I lived with people who had a hunting license, since I would probably, you know, we probably would, but we don't. So... No geese he's eating for me. So yeah. Still eat it. Roast goose is a thing for you? interesting, because that's not really a thing for where I live in the good old America. There goes the hell site. I probably need to change the timer a little bit. Because the links aren't really separated properly. Actually, I'm going to go get Live 2D out. Just give it a moment. Okay, open recent file. So I probably need to like my mom replied. She just said, "Sheesh." You just guess they aren't afraid of the cat. Well, we aren't really hunters, so no, kiddo. That is not dinner. Okay. Still looking a little cursed, but at least we have the, At least the eyes will look a little better. So,
fuck.
So now I need to okay. Now there we go. Now. That should work. Okay, there we go. Okay, there we go. Okay. Why does this look so cursed? Why? Look like that. Thank you. Okay. I am currently in the most cursed part of this process. Because geez Louise. Okay. Fuck. Okay. Fuck. There's the bounding box. Okay. So now I kind of like need to correct this. Thank you. Okay. Hold on, I'm going to turn off the mouth for this. Mostly so I can, like, get this stuff right. So I'm kind of just like fine tuning based on like the inputs of the auto generated motion. And of course it ended up being a little scuffed, but that's kind of what happened with Live 2D. Oh, I should probably, like, hide the eyes, too. Okay. I need to okay. So, what the fuck? I mean, should I have probably avoided doing the auto-generated motion and try to, like, learn how to do this manually? Yes. I probably should have done that. But did I? Nope. It is a tool that had I have the ability to use, so I am going to use it. And if it does lead to some little fuck-ups. And also, I probably should have, like, kept the line art on a separate layer for this. So, yeah. Fuck. Had to do the neck crackle crackle. Crackle crackle pop. Mm-hmm. The mesh is still a bit of a mess right now. Okay. I mean, hopefully once I'm, you know, able to kind of tweak the model a little bit. And I will be able to, you know, make this look not so cursed. So to be fair, I probably made the angle a little too extreme. I don't know. In hindsight, I probably should have, like, made the... I should have kept the fucking line art separate. Yeah, this looks really, really wonky. I'm going to probably like Apparently the microphone was muted. But yeah. I'll be seeing y'all on Friday doing Skyrim. Bye.